People often ask Paula Abdul about her nationality. She says she's Syrian, Brazilian, French-Canadian, and All-American. An All-American girl holding at number three with Forever Your Girl. I'm Casey Kasem. Casey's Top 40 originates in Hollywood. That means we've got a brand new number one song in the USA. And even though it's the third number one in a row for Paula Abdul, she says sometimes people treat her like an invisible woman. And what does she mean by invisible? Actually, you might have experienced the same thing. Having people look at you and not see you, like they were gazing right through you. Paula says she's even been in important meetings with executives who walk right by her and tell their secretaries, get Paula Abdul on the phone. She's not here yet. Well, since Paula's had number one hits with Straight Up and Forever You're a Girl and is choreographed for such superstars as the Jacksons, Aretha Franklin, and Dan Aykroyd, you'd think people would at least know her when they see her. But according to Paula, the problem is they don't see her, even though they look right at her. She says that's because she's so short and petite, 5'2". She usually takes people who don't know her by surprise. And 26-year-old Paula says, quote, they look at me and they're expecting this big image of an older person, much taller. It's really funny what people perceive me as being. Paula says that while she gets a kick out of people's misconceptions, it's sometimes a drag when they don't take her seriously. She says she's even had them look at her and demand to know how old she is. But Paula adds that once people see her at work, there's never any question about her ability. Well, this week, the Invisible Woman's impossible to miss. After two straight number ones in a row, Paula Abdul's got her third. The new number one song in the USA is Cold Hearted by Paula Abdul. Number three. Also holding steady this week is the latest from an L.A. singer who says she keeps her body and voice in shape by jogging 2 miles each morning and singing her entire concert set on the way. Right now, Paula Abdul's singing on Casey's Top 40 from the album Forever Your Girl. Here's The Way That You Love Me. Hi, this is Casey Kasem. Well, last week on Casey's Top 40, Paula Abdul's amazing success story continued as she went to number one again, this time with her hit Opposites Attract. That gives Paula a total of 4 number ones from her very first album. No other female singer, not even Madonna or Whitney Houston, has that distinction. This week, Paula will try to extend her stay at the top, but it's going to be tough because Janet Jackson is closing in fast. Who will be number one? Join us as we count down all the action this weekend right here on Casey's Top 40. Casey's Top 40. From Hollywood, I'm Casey Kasem. Now, we're up to the number one song in the USA on Casey's Top 40, and it's by a superstar who choreographer Paula Abdul says dances like no one else she's ever worked with. Paula says with this superstar, you gotta throw away all the rules. You know, over the years, Paula's worked with a lot of big talents. She's taught new dance steps to Debbie Gibson, George Michael, and Dolly Parton, among others. But she says the one who stands out is none other than the woman who's at number one this week. Paula told us that usually, dancers have picked up their style from someone else. But this week's number one seems to have created her own dance style in her head. There's no imitation when it comes to her, not even imitation of her famous brother, Michael. Paula says, quote, if I had to describe her style, which isn't easy to do, I'd say it was defined by isolated movements. She does a whole series of movements, but she pauses between each one. Everything she does is like snap, punch, bang, bang, then stop, then start all over again. According to Paula, coming up with dance steps for her is almost impossible. Paula says, quote, it works only if I throw everything I know out the window. We start fresh as if we're inventing dancing, and we see where it takes us. Well, this week, the superstar with that unique style of dance is still dancing her heart out at the top of the chart, dancing there longer than she's ever done before. The number one song in the USA on Casey's Top 40 for the 4th week in a row is Janet Jackson's biggest number one ever, Escapade. Casey's
Top 40. I'm Mark Elliott sitting in for Casey Kasem. Now we're up to the number one song in the USA on Casey's Top 40. And it's by a woman whose super successful singing career began as a lark. She began in show business as a dancer, First an L.A. Laker cheerleader and then a choreographer. She taught steps to stars like Janet Jackson, George Michael, Duran Duran, and many others. And working with those musicians, she became friends with a lot of backup singers. Well, one day a couple of those backup singers heard this choreographer singing to herself, and they asked her if she'd like to sing along with them on a demo tape they were making. The dancer told us she didn't really take it all that seriously. It just sounded like a lot of fun, getting together with a bunch of girls and spending an afternoon singing. Well, the singers liked the way the demo tape came out, so they passed it along to someone they knew at Motown Records. Motown told them it was nice, but no thanks. Then the singers sent a copy of the tape to someone they knew at Virgin Records, and Virgin also told them it was nice and no thanks. But who was that one woman who sang solo in the middle of the song? Well, it turned out the solo singer they were interested in was, who else, the singing choreographer. So the label had her record a demo on her own, and they decided they definitely liked what they heard. The result was a recording contract for that dancer who just made the demo for fun, and a string of number ones, Straight Up, Forever Your Girl, Cold Hearted, Opposites Attract, and the song that this week is once again the biggest hit in the land. The number one song in the USA on Casey's Top 40 is Rush Rush by Paula Abdul.
Music. Talk about a homecoming. When Paula Abdul's Spellbound tour returned to L.A. recently, she was treated like a hero. First, she was presented with a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. Then, when she finished one of her sold-out shows at the Forum, home of the Lakers, Magic Johnson appeared on stage to honor Paula by informing her that her old Laker girl uniform was being retired.
Music.
We'll cancel that Forever Your Girl stuff. Our lead story. After 2 years as husband and wife, Paula Abdul filed for divorce from actor Emilio Estevez. It was the first marriage for both of them, and it was the one most people thought had a chance. Paula said, "It's with tremendous reluctance and great sadness that I've taken this action." American Top 40. Now, Hammer probably gets a lot of mail, but the singer at number 36 gets about 5,000 letters a week. And Paula Abdul told us about one letter that she'll never forget.
I pinned this up on my refrigerator because it really cracked me up. I got a letter from a farmer who said that he plays Straight Up for his cows while he's milking them because the cows produce more milk and it serenades them. And I thought, well, I've never received a letter for that. And then at the end, it closed by saying, "Would you be my wife because we could live on a farm together and you could serenade my cows?" I thought, that's really a great proposal.
So tell, baby, tell. The hits from coast to coast, coast to coast.
Shadoe Stevens, American Top 40. Now, this next song has a twist. A couple have been together for a while, and when the day finally comes to talk marriage, she gets down on one knee and proposes to him. Paula Abdul told us the idea behind her latest hit at number 13.
I remember going to the family stand saying that I want to write a song about a girl getting up the courage to ask the guy to marry her. And they laughed at me and thought it was really corny. But when we really talked about it, they understood that it could be really cool because it is the 90s and it sometimes it's difficult and a girl shouldn't feel like it always has to be the guy who asks the girl to marry him. Maybe it's a big relief for the guys. I don't know. But I think it's a song that's really heartfelt.
Just go.
One year ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was The Promise of a New Day by a singer who was recently named Humanitarian of the Year for all the help she's given to terminally ill children. The group that gave her this honor is the Starlight Foundation, one of several organizations that make wishes come true for terminally ill children. Over the years, they've given their humanitarian award to superstars like Elizabeth Taylor, Janet Jackson, and Steven Spielberg. And this year, they gave it to a singer and dancer who's always made herself available for children whose wish it was to meet her and to see her perform.
Casey's Biggest Hits.
3 years ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was Opposites Attract by a singer whose career got a big boost when she won a dance scholarship at the tender age of 10. This superstar in the making from Los Angeles had started dancing when she was only 5, taking lessons in tap and ballet. By the time she was 10, she was so good she earned a scholarship at one of Hollywood's most respected dance schools, the Bell Lewitsky Studio. She quickly became the school's number one star, and she learned the technique she would use a decade later to revolutionize the dancing and music videos. 3 years ago this week, this dance prodigy had one of the biggest hits in the USA. Opposites Attract.
Count them down with Casey Kasem.
Also rising three notches to number 23 on Casey's Top 40 is Paula Abdul. In making her latest CD, Head Over Heels, she used 15 different producers working in 24 different studios. And all those producers agree on one thing. Paula was in control as the unifying thread in the music.
Casey's Top 40.
I'm Casey Kasem. Our countdown of the top 100 of 1995 originates in Hollywood. And rolling in at number 74, here's another one. She's Paula Abdul, a woman who overcame some of life's toughest obstacles in 1995. First, Paula went through a difficult divorce that she says truly tested her emotions. And she also won her battle with the eating disorder called bulimia, a battle she spoke about in numerous magazine and TV interviews. Here's Paula Abdul with My Love Is For Real.
Counting them down.